What up, guys? Here we are at Revoke Performance.
Hello, hi.
We have here Jared, the super infamous TikToker now for Panigale. And we have the turtle, my Ninja ZX6R is in the shop. And the reason that it's in the shop is because of...
Okay, today we are going to do a ZX6 link pipe for the 2010 model to 2014. This is a 2010 or 2013. We're gonna do a link pipe mold, so we're gonna make a jig. That's why we are engaging the special services of Mr. Cyborg here to help us to pinjam us his mic.
Yeah, basically I'm just here to disturb him while he does his mock-up templates, rig jigs, all the good stuff that mechanics do. And if you guys are wondering what is Revoke, they are specialists in doing exhaust, custom exhaust, not just custom, right? You do the
pull systems,
slip-ons.
We specialize in a lot of Ducati exhaust and we ship them overseas. Amongst them is for the Panigale V4, Panigale V2, Street Fighter V2 and also V4.
So yep. All Ducati guys, if you haven't heard of Revoke, definitely check it out. So for that, we will let Jared do his thing with my Ninja, my turtle, and we'll check out behind the scenes.
You're right.
This is the long pipe.
So boleh potong 2 inci, 4.2 inci, panjang dia 4.5 inci.
So Jared, what type of stainless steel pipes do you use for your exhaust?
For our exhaust, we use the size that is recommended, the grade that is recommended, which is 304, stainless steel 304.
What is 304?
That is the grade that is suitable for automotive, cars, sport cars and also for super bikes, where it handles and dissipates heat well and it lasts. Now what we did is
well,
we had to expand the pipe so it could fit inside this section.
So
perfect fit.
No need for any gaskets.
No need, because inside you already have a gasket here.
Oh yeah.
So we utilize this gasket and we just put it.
So close, ah.
Yes. Actually, it's not close there.
But this one, I mean, the angle should be, I mean, from my point of view, isn't it supposed to be?
Yes, correct. You're right. I thought it was the distance. Angle, yes. That one we can pushing the muffler.
You fine tune it after that.
Yeah, correct. Cool. That's the last step.
So you can see my honeycomb is still there. Got a full system.
We prefer our pipes to have jarak yang agak sekata so that the well will look nice. That's why we use long elbows. 45 degree long elbows, we use long elbows. So that it will look sekata.
What about those that like to do that tiny?
Tiny one can, but that is because of it's a very tight angle. And the tiny one, there's no function. It's more to looks.
looks.
More to function. No function, but more to looks. Yeah. For us, we prefer clean looks. So that's why we prefer not too many wells. So like for this pipe, there's only 1, 2, 3, 4 wells.
Yeah. Nice.
Tengah pipe tu, eh? Nah, ingat tengah. Yeah. So this is how we mark the spring. 2 marks up and bottom. Yes, as well. Come on, you can do it. Yes. Yeah, so this is what the ZX6 slip-on Reebok T1 would look like with a long link pipe and a medium-sized muffler, 320mm from here to here. Stainless steel finish with carbon fiber tip and with a DB killer that is removable. And also, it comes with a carbon fiber hanger. We will feature it later.
Awesome. So, if other models of your Reebok?
Or which one? This bike?
For, if let's say I don't want this, I want some other pattern. The link pipe is still going to be the same or different?
If you want a high mount, it will be the same angle. But if you want a low mount,
oh, like shorty like
shorty
that.
Shorty like that, then it will be different. The link pipe will be something like maybe just like that.
So you need to make another.
Make another one. Make but another usually one. We will tell customers why the long one is better and try to close the deal in the long one first lah. Alright, so after this, we will brush it. We will remove this glossy. We will remove this glossy look. We
why?
Will brush it and then we will weld it.
Why you need to remove the glossy look?
For looks. It doesn't look so nice, kilat-kilat macam tu.
Unless the guy wants it kilat-kilat.
Unless the guy minta kilat, kita bagi kilat lah. But if not, we will brush it first and then we will weld.
So it will, brush means it will look like
yes, this. Brush it will look like this, but with the welds. Yeah.
Okay.
So there's a difference, is it? Brush and no brush. We always prefer to brush the surface. It looks better. It looks classier.
Okay.
So this is the look after we brush it before we weld. So we make sure everywhere is brushed very evenly from start to finish, and there's no more glossy look that you can find. Then we weld. So brushing is also to remove oil and remove dust so that our weld becomes easier. So guys, the way we weld is we do not use fillers all the time. If the pipes are very tight to each other, we don't need to use the filler. Contrary to popular belief that you have to use the filler each and every time. So we just weld it like this, and when we use the filler is when there are bigger gaps, then only we will use the filler and fill it up. So apart from that, we just normally weld like that, so it has a very clean and tidy finish. So this exhaust, and in fact all our T1 series and our carbon, full carbon exhaust, comes with genuine carbon fiber hanger. Yes guys, this is real carbon fiber, not water transfer, bukan celup ke apa-apa, alright, real carbon fiber. Slightly longer screw. this big enough. Should do the work. So, can you give me a washer biasa tanpa bukan lock ni?
So for you guys that are wondering why there's a missing bush, it's because I'm using the Shorty exhaust and the bush is somewhere in my storeroom in the lost and forgotten section. But this mock-up is just to make sure the boat is long enough.
Okay.
Not too far away.
Boleh.
Boleh.
Yeah.
Okay. Just two spots. So then we will bring it back there to give it a full TIG weld.
Alright, so for this bracket to weld on the pipe, we will use a filler because there is a gap that we need to fill up. So we will use a 2.4mm filler rod to fill up this place here. So guys, we have already filled up and welded the 2.5 stainless steel filler rod to this side of the bracket. So this is how it looks like. 2.4mm is the right size, not too big, not too small.
So the black burn look, you can scrub it later?
We can scrub it off later, but it will not be too obvious later on.
Alright.
Okay, we are done, front and back. We'll clean it up a little bit. Lap-lap-lap, kesan jari, cap jari, fingernail, oil stains, minyak, baru kemas.
The pipe also need to wipe.
If there is dirt and oil, yes, we just rub it as well.
Alright guys, so here we are finally done at Revoke Performance. Jared has custom fabricated this from scratch and it only took him like 60 seconds, I'm just kidding, but almost 60 seconds. He worked fast like fucking lightning like that. I needed to chase him everywhere just to see what he's doing. So Jared, just a quick one,
yep.
Give us a summary on your procedure on making this.
Alright, so for the ZX6, it's a straightforward bike, the exhaust that we do. So it took us about 30 to 40 minutes to finish everything from start to finish. So size, we make sure sizing is correct, angle is correct, distance is correct. So yeah, thanks to Cybot for bringing his bike for us to test out the sample. We appreciate it very much. You guys are awesome.
So guys, before we wrap it up, just to let you guys know, I'll share all the Revoke stuff, the social medias and all that, how you can disturb Jared or contact him to basically make you a exhaust. Or give you a quote for exhaust. There's various mufflers, as I shown also in the video. There's various mufflers that is from Revoke Performance, so you can check those as well if you don't prefer this type of large exhaust. So that's it for me. I hope you guys enjoy the behind the scenes trying to trace this guy. So catch you on the next one, guys. Till
Thank
then,
you.
This is the Cybot here.
Bye.
Ride safe and safe ride.